Hello, in this tutorial I will show you how to create a flexible AI that is able to patrol along a platform just by using events. As you can see, we only have two game objects in the scene, so let's take a look at them. Our enemy comes with a default platformer character behavior. These three variables are for ground checking and the direction of the character. I'm going to explain them in more detail in the logic section of this video. The platform holds a platform behavior and a tween, which is used for animating the platform. It was just added for demonstration purposes. So let's have a look at the actual game logic. Before we are going through the events step by step, I'd like to talk a little about the cast array condition, which is the core of the whole behavior. So let me visualize this condition to make it a little easier to understand. The object we are casting the ray against is the platform our enemy is walking on. In your own game, you should pick a group here that contains all the different platforms the enemy is able to walk on. Next, we set the origin of the ray by specifying its x and y coordinate. To do so, we pick the right side of the enemy's bounding box as the x coordinate, and the bottom of the bounding box for the y coordinate. By doing so, the origin of the ray is located at the bottom right corner of the enemy sprite. The next thing to do is giving it a direction. Since we picked the angle-based variant of the ray cast condition, we need to insert the angle that points downwards. As you can see, this is 90 degrees. Lastly, we need to specify the length of the ray. In this case, the length doesn't really matter, since the platform is directly underneath the enemy. If you choose a longer distance, the ray might intersect with another platform below the current one, which would make the enemy jump down and continue walking on the other as well. We could also save the hit position of the ray in a scene variable, but since we don't need the exact coordinates, we will leave it blank. And now back to the event sheet. In the first step, we are creating a repeat loop that executes the sub-events for every instance of the enemy object in the scene. Before I'm going to talk about the two variables ground exists left and right, we need to have another look at the cast array condition, since it works a little different than other conditions. Since the cast array condition checks for the intersection of the ray and an object instance, one would assume that inverting the condition would generate a true impulse when there is no such intersection detected. But unfortunately, this is not the case here. In its normal state, the cast array condition returns true when the ray intersects with an object instance and filters out the first one it hits. In its inverted state, however, it picks the last instance that it intersects with instead. So since we have no built-in way to notice when the function does not detect anything, we need to add the logic for the lacking functionality ourselves. To do so, we create two Boolean variables, groundExistsRight and groundExistsLeft, for checking both sides of the enemy and assign the value false to them. This way we assume that the ray won't hit anything, but if it does, we set the corresponding variable to true. Now that we have added the missing functionality, we are finally able to recognize when the ray hits thin air. So in case the groundExistsLeft or right variables still hold the value false, after the ray is cast, we can change the direction variable of the enemy to make it walk the other way. In the last step, we check in which direction the enemy is going to walk after we have acquired all the necessary information, simulate the button presses, and flip the sprite according to its movement direction. If you like to experiment with the logic on your own, you can find a download link in the description below. So, thanks for watching and see you in the next video. If you want to see more of this channel, hit the like button and subscribe. Bye-bye.